Hello there. So far, we have seen the basic programming structure and constructs of the MATLAB programming, and we have done some simple image processing like reading the image, displaying it, and doing some RGB to gray conversion. In this session, what we are going to do is we are going to study how we can handle the images into the same window. For example, if I read two different images like this, and if I want to do some processing onto it, or by doing anything, I want to see them side by side. What I do is, this is how I read an image called A is equal to I am read lena.jpg, B is equal to I am read, and here I'll say tech output.bmp. And if I have to display both of these images, then what I do is I am show A and I am show B. Now the problem that happens with this kind of programming is this. I'm only looking at the second image, that is the B, but the Lena image is not visible over here. What is happening here is, first the Lena image was displayed, and then immediately the second B image was displayed, that is output.bmp. So the first image was erased. We can check it also using a simple function called pause. Pause is just like a normal time delay function in MATLAB. You can just use pause and pass on some number of seconds of delay you want. So what we do is we show A first, take a delay of 2 seconds, and then show the B image. Let's see what happens with it. So the Lena is visible now, and after 2 seconds, it just got changed. Now to avoid that, what we can do is we can simply have figure and then I am show A, and then figure and again I am show B. Now one image is shown, and after 2 seconds another figure 2 is displayed where we can see the other image. Now what I want to do here is I want to display both the images into the same window. For that, let's go to this search documentation and search for a function called subplot. The documentation is very nice and it gives you the description of every single function that is present in the MATLAB. You just have to search for it. So subplot creates axes in tiled position. The syntax is very simple. Subplot m, n, p, where m is equal to the number of x-axis, n is y-axis, and p is where to print. So I'm just doing these two lines as commented and will immediately try a simple routine of it. By just giving a percentage symbol, you can comment any line into the MATLAB. Now I want to show this onto the same image. So what I'll do here is, first subplot 1, 2. So I want x-axis, means single row, to be split into two columns, and in the first column I'll print here, instead of giving a semicolon, we can just give a comma, and then you can give figure, sorry, not figure, but we'll give I am show A. You can also give a comma here and then give title, this is Lena. Then subplot 1, 2, that is the same subplot which is x-axis divided into two parts, and into the second part, the last two signifies second part, I want to display I am show B, and let's give title, this is output dot bmp, just some image that I had. And now let's run it. Now what will happen here is, see, isn't it interesting? So this is how you can handle two images at the same time. Now let's forget about the output.bmp, or let's just keep output.bmp. But now let's take their grayed image also. So what we'll do is, subplot x is divided into two axes and y is also divided into two axes. So what will happen is, we'll have a 4-quadrant square subplot created. So A, the original images are displayed. So this is, or let's say Lena RGB, and here let's say output RGB. Then what I'll do is A1 is equal to RGB2 gray, and here I'll give A, and B1 is equal to RGB2 gray, and I'll give here B. Then using the same function, what we need to do is we need to print it over subplot 3, subplot 4, A1, B1, and this is Lena gray, and this is output gray. Let's run this. So that's how you handle images with MATLAB into the same window. You can try out different things over here. The help section will show all the different varieties that you can do. So you can not only choose to have just two axes like this, one after another, just dividing x into two. So it will be subplot 2 comma 1 comma 1 and subplot 2 comma 1 comma 2. You can also have different sized images like this. So to do this, this is how it's done. Subplot 2 comma 2 comma 1, 2 comma 2 comma 2, and then subplot 2 comma 2 comma 3, 4. Both the places 3 and 4 are specified in the same space here. So what I want you to do is try out these samples which are given into this documentation and see how subplotting works for you. Thanks for watching this video, and just try the experiments for sure. Thank you.